Thanks, Bill, and good afternoon to everyone. Welcome. Appreciate y'all all being with us. My name's Steve Watson. I'm the athletic director here at Loyola, and I'm joined today by our head men's basketball coach, Drew Valentine, our president, Dr. Joanne Rooney, and the commissioner of the Atlantic 10 Conference, Bernadette McGlade. Now, please clap for them. Thank you. As you know, we're here to talk about the exciting announcement we made yesterday. I'm going to operate under the assumption that we all read our press release, so we're going to make some very brief comments. We'll take just a few questions up here once we're done speaking, and then the three of us, Dr. Rooney has an engagement she's going to jump to right after we get done, but the three of us are going to make ourselves available for some follow-up questions at stations around the floor. So that's kind of our plan of attack. I'd like to start my comments with a huge thank you to the Missouri Valley Conference. And that's really been the hard part about this process, is telling the Valley that we're leaving. Almost 9 years ago, the Valley took a big chance on Loyola, and the Valley's been a great home for us. The Valley represents everything that's good in college athletics, and while we'll miss so many things about the league, we're really looking forward to finishing this year strong as a great member in the Valley. If you read our press releases and have listened to some of the messages we've sent out, you've heard us say, and you'll continue to hear us say, that we aren't running from the Valley, we're running to the Atlantic 10. And that's definitely the case. We're super excited to join a league with a great history, tradition of high academic achievement, along with competitive success. I don't want to speak for our coaches and student athletes, but I can tell you all I'm hearing from them is how excited they are to travel to New York City, to Washington, D.C., to Philadelphia, and of course to Olean, New York. That's where I grew up in Olean, I'm sorry. But travel to places on the East Coast, some great cities that are the homes of the schools in the Atlantic 10 Conference. So we feel very confident, and when I say we, I'm also including Sister Jean in that, because she has given this move her blessing. So we, including Sister Jean, all feel very confident that the Atlantic 10 is the perfect fit for the Loyola Ramblers. So thank you very much. And now I'm going to turn it over to our president, I mentioned earlier, Dr. Joanne Rooney, who's going to share her comments. Thank you.
Great. Thanks so much, Steve. And again, thanks everyone for being with us. I share Steve's comment, though, that none of us are used to this being quite so quiet. So we're looking forward to getting back to the enthusiastic and great support that everyone's given to all of us and to all of our teams. I also want to echo something that Steve said as well, which is we are extremely grateful for our time in the Missouri Valley Conference and truly appreciate what can only be described as great collegiality from the other presidents in the league, the athletic directors, student and staff athletes, during now what has been a 9-year stay in the league. And while we look back at nearly a decade in the Valley very, very fondly and very gratefully, you can tell that we are so enthusiastic for what lies ahead in the A-10 Conference. The A-10 Conference is widely regarded as one of the top leagues in the country for its success, of course, athletically, but especially as important, academically. And we're really looking forward to competing in a league with a handful of our sister Jesuit schools as well, Fordham, St. Joe's, and St. Louis, as well as so many other like-minded institutions. It really looks to us to be an exciting, exciting future. We believe this is the right move at the right time for Loyola. And it does definitely position us for continued brand growth on a national basis, to reach into new and vibrant markets, and for even greater success in competition, but of course, as you know, in the classroom as well. So I echo great enthusiasm and really appreciate our time in the Valley, but especially this great warm welcome that we've already been receiving from our A-10 colleagues. Thanks so much, and thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Dr. Rooney. Now, Next up is the commissioner of the Atlantic 10 Conference, Bernadette McGlade. But before she starts, I'm going to present her with a scarf. And now, as the commissioner of the league, she has to be neutral during the regular season. But when we go on to the postseason, we're going to make sure that, that Bernadette has a scarf to wear when she cheers on the Ramblers. So I'm going to give this to her as she starts her comments. Please give a hand to Bernadette.
Thank you, Steve. And as they say, when in Rome, do as the Romans, right? So we'll have these for all the pictures. I just want to send a sincere thanks to President Rooney for your leadership during this process, to Steve Watson, Coach Valentine, it's great that you're here, and certainly to all the other coaches that are here today. This is an exciting time. It's an exciting opportunity. The Atlantic 10 is a proud, proud basketball-centric conference. We are proud not only of what we do in intercollegiate athletics and our championships that we host for 21 sports, but we are proud, as Dr. Rooney said, that we are in the top five in the national graduation rates and the GSRs. So that's something that's very important to us and is something that's important to the profile of all of our member institutions. We have a saying, a motto that we go by in the Atlantic 10, great people, great places, and outstanding opportunities. Outstanding opportunities is what we are looking at right now with this opportunity to go from 14 to 15 member institutions. We are looking forward to having another institution that geographically balanced the Atlantic 10. We also are looking at the fact that our media markets are certainly growing incrementally, and is something that, as we know, intercollegiate athletics often is the front porch of an institution. And the fact that we have one of the best national media packages in the country, every single time that our teams, and specifically our teams in men's and women's basketball, are on national television, which is over 85 times a year, your institution is going right into the homes of everyone across America. And for your value alums that don't have the opportunity to come to this great facility every time that you happen to play either home or away. I want to say a special thank you also to everyone that has been so cooperative. The media has been tremendous in the pre-announcement yesterday and also today. We have the opportunity to really elevate not only what we do in the Atlantic 10 from a brand value as it relates to academics, as it relates to intercollegiate athletics, but also in terms of our commitment to diversity, to inclusion, to gender equity, and all of the hallmark traits that we feel are so critical to the Atlantic 10 and all of our member institutions. This institution, your institution, now is part of a group of members that take all of this really seriously. We are excited. We are excited about our Commission on Gender Equity, Diversity, Inclusion, and Justice. We are excited about the opportunities that we offer over 5,000 student athletes in the area of postseason championships. And we're even more excited when we launch any of our teams into postseason NCAA championship play. So on behalf of the membership, on behalf of our athletic directors, on behalf of our current 14 presidents and chancellors, I just want to say that we are as thrilled as you are that you will be joining the Atlantic 10 Conference, and we're looking forward to accelerating the timeline, if we could even do that, but we are actually looking so forward to the start of 2022-23 year. So thank you for the opportunity, and we're looking forward to this next step.
Thank you. Thank you, Bernadette. Hopefully you'll be able to wear that scarf at all the Rambler postseason appearances. Hopefully that'll happen frequently.
Absolutely. And we actually did bring a very small, understated coaster for President Rooney and for our coaches here and all of the administration. And Sister Jean, we are certainly thrilled to have you part of the conference. And I think, Drew, don't we have something for Sister Jean as well? Bill, you want to get it? And This will be something that you can use to keep you nice and warm.
And Drew, I'm not even going to ask you to start talking because Sister Jean's going to get the attention of everybody here for a couple seconds. We're all used to that. Thank you, Bernadette. And finally, we'll get a chance to hear from our undefeated head men's basketball coach, Drew Valentine. Drew, come on, clap.
Really? Yes, sir, baby.
Guys, your team didn't even clap for
us. I was about to say, man. My guys, come on, man. Let's go.
We'll be running today.
Got my guys in here deep. I want to echo the comments that Steve and Dr. Rooney both said, and just speak on behalf of not only my coaching staff but all the coaches here at Loyola, and just thank the Valley for being a great home for us for the past 10 years. I've had some really good memories. Our programs had really good memories being a part of Missouri Valley Conference. So just thanks to them for being a great home for us for almost 10 years. But moving on, I couldn't be more excited, as Steve and Dr. Rooney talked about joining the A-10, one of the top conferences in the country, and one that is also basketball centric, which fits into what we do here at Loyola. The A-10 obviously is a multi-bid league in men's basketball, and has had 34 bids to the NCAA tournament over the past 10 years, which is going to give us a really good opportunity to get into the NCAA tournament and compete at a high level. Obviously, there's a ton of teams in the A-10, just like us, who have a rich tradition of basketball success. Other teams that advance in the tournament, get to Final Fours, postseason play. So we're excited about competing against those other teams, and just like they all spoke about, joining the Atlantic 10 also gives Loyola basketball the opportunity to get into a bunch of other really large media markets around the country, and will help us hopefully cast a wider net from the recruiting aspect as we can get into other markets too. So extremely excited to be joining the Atlantic 10, and I'm really honored to be up here speaking with you guys during this. So thank you.
Thanks, Drew. I'm going to turn it over to Bill. I think we're going to offer up the opportunity to ask a few questions before we break off into as individuals. Got one right here, Kristen.
James K. Chicago Tribune. When you talk about this pairing between Loyola and the Atlantic 10, like, why was it a perfect match, and how long did the process take for it to get to this point?
I'll jump in and talk about why it was a perfect match, and we've touched on it a little bit, but when you look up and down the list of the schools that are in the Atlantic 10, you see a lot of schools that are like us. Dr. Rooney mentioned that there are other Jesuit schools in the conference, private Catholics. All the way up and down the league, there's a strong academic academic profile for all of the schools in the league. And then for us, as we're looking at rivalries, and you go back in history and you look at some of the schools that we've played historically, there's some natural rivalries for us. So in addition to the Jesuit schools in SLU, you've got Dayton and Fordham, St. Joe's, St. Bonaventure, some private Catholics that make sense for us, but then some really strong basketball schools that have been to the Final Four, VCU, George Mason. You go up to UMass and Rhode Island. So there's just a natural fit for us from a rivalry standpoint. You talk about the markets that Drew mentioned, getting into New York and Philly and DC. That's another great draw for us. And then finally, the fact that they make no bones about being a basketball-centric conference, and that's what we are here at Loyola as well. So you look at all the different things that make up the league, and I think Bernie has said it a number of times, we check all their boxes, but they check all of our boxes as well.
Do you want me to try, man?
If you want to jump in, sure.
From the conference perspective, A lot of the very similar things that Steve just said from the institutional side, but essentially, we are a conference, we're 14-member institutions, we don't need to expand, we don't need to go to 15, we don't need to go to 16. But if there is an opportunity to bring in an institution that has similar values, and we look at the academic profile, we look at the athletic profile, we look at the leadership within the institution, we look at the geographic footprint, we look at how is that compatible with our other member institutions, we look at the student athlete enrollment of the graduation rates of adherence to NCAA rules and compliance. So it's a whole package of evaluation points, not unlike when a coach is recruiting and trying to select different student athletes that really fit their programs. And so we were in really a unique situation, and as a basketball-centric league, the only institutions that we really look at and evaluate really closely are also similar institutions that are basketball-centric and that match up in, on all of those measuring points. And this institution, your institution, has matched that perfectly. And the timing and the synergy in terms of our communications and ability to be able to bring this partnership together happened to be able to emerge over the last most recent time period.
Yeah, Kevin Sweeney from Sports Illustrated. I know Drew mentioned that the A-10 is a traditionally a multi-bid basketball league. Can you speak to how much that factored into the decision to choose the Atlantic 10?
Sure. You know, it goes back to that being a basketball-centric league, and I'll get the stat wrong, but one of the stats I saw was in the last 10 years, I think the A-10 had 24. Does that sound right? 24 at-large bids, and you know that's pretty attractive for a school like Loyola, and so that's always going to be one of our goals is to get to the tournament, and obviously we've had success in advancing once we get there, and so we want to position ourselves in a place where we can best have the opportunity to get to the postseason, and we feel like the Atlantic 10 puts us in that position.
How you doing? Mike McGraw, Daily Herald. With all sports considered, is this going to make travel easier, harder, the same? What's your perception of that?
I didn't major in geography when I was in college, but I can tell you, and we've talked to our coaches about this, it's just going to be different. You know, we've spent a lot of time in buses in the valley, and now we're going to spend some time in planes. And that's going to be a budget hit that we're going to have to look at, but it's important to note, I think, that we're entering into the Atlantic 10 in a similar way than when we entered into the Missouri Valley Conference. We're not just going into the league to be a part of it. We want to compete for championships, and we understand and realize that in order for us to do that, there's a financial commitment. And you know, one of the last things that I'm going to say here today is I'm going to thank some people who have assured us that the university is going to continue to support us in a way that we're going to be able to compete for championships, and that's really, really important. So from a travel standpoint, yeah, our teams are going to be flying, but we're going to make sure that we're able to travel. We're going to continue to feed our athletes the way they need to be fed and to provide them the resources they need to be successful, and a part of that's going to be we're going to be traveling a little bit differently. But they're excited about it. You know, they're excited about jumping on a plane and going to New York and playing Fordham and going to D.C. and playing George Washington and George Mason. It's an exciting time for our athletes, and that's the one thing that we keep hearing from our coaches and athletes is how getting into these markets is going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, Steve, if I can add on to that. So I agree with you. It will certainly be an investment, but we also look at it and say the opportunities for our student athletes to be competing in New York, Philly, Washington, and some other spots, as well as we recognize we have alums around the world, but in all of these major cities. So we think it's going to create some great opportunities, not just for our student athletes, but really for Rambler alumni in these areas who are already reaching out to us and very excited about the opportunities to be part of this on a very different level. And it's something we also considered.
Let me just I want to close with just something real quick. I want to thank Bill Behrens and Drew Dickerson who put this together today. Thank all the Loyola coaches, staff, and our athletes who are here, and of course Sister Jean for coming. But also some people that work behind the scenes to make this happen and to make this possible. Wayne Madgers, the university CFO, Tom Kelly, our senior VP of administrative services, is in the back, and I'd really appreciate if you'd give him a round of applause, please. You won't find a better advocate for Loyola Athletics than Tom Kelly, and also some of our folks in our department are here, our Deputy Athletic Director, Holly Strauss O'Brien, Senior Associate AD, Tom Saboro, and also our Assistant AD for Finance, Kristen Rasparsky, who's rolled up her sleeves a little bit these last few weeks to make sure that we're doing the things we need to do to get into the Atlantic 10 successfully. So just to wrap it up, Bill, and then I'll turn it back over to you. You know, Ramblers everywhere are super excited. I think Dr. Rooney said it well about our alumni, and we fully intend to continue to make those Ramblers proud. So thank you very much.